Josh Spiegel, News Genius, regaled us with the tale last week, and then an update this week. Last week, you were telling us about parents that were attempting to evict their son, Michael, 30 years old, New York. They sent him letter after letter after letter after letter, and they finally had to take him to court, and the results were...
The judge ruled in the parents' favor.
Time to get up and to...
Get him out.
Get him out.
He's got to be out in 30 days.
You're going to be living on the street, white boy. You hear about them giving him $1,100. He just blew that on something. He said bills. What bills do you have? Okay, it definitely isn't on Pert Plus because you look like you rub olive oil into your hair, and it ain't on Mach 3 blades because that face is a disaster. So what the hell is with this guy? What the hell is with the freeloaders? The failure to launch. 410-338.
Come on, man. See, but he says they weren't doing his laundry and they weren't providing him food. That's the two main reasons you move in with your parents. My mom would definitely do all my laundry, and I would have meals at all times.
I'd be too embarrassed.
Are you kidding me?
To let my family do my laundry. It's a mess.
She's seen it all.
Let's go to the phones. What is the situation? Let's talk to Jody in Mount Airy. Jody, thank you for holding.
Hi, guys. First, I want to say I love your show. So my 31-year-old sister lives with my parents.
Oh, God.
She works full-time but doesn't contribute to any of the bills in my parents' house.
Whoa!
She comes and goes as she pleases, and then when my mom gets upset with her for coming in at midnight and making a ruckus, they get in yelling matches.
Yeah.
My sister has also stolen money from not only my parents but my grandmother.
Is she on drugs?
No, just to go out and party. She would go to bars and then post pictures on her Facebook page. And recently, I confronted my sister as I'm a single mom of three. I live on my own. I work full time.
Hell yeah. Look at you making it happen.
I can tell just by the tone of your voice that you are pissed about this.
It is. It does piss me off because my parents... She has stolen probably in the whole time she's lived with my parents about $10,000 from them.
Have her arrested. Screw kicking her out.
Yeah, and, this is over a period of time, so it's just little amounts every single time. Recently, my mother and father saved up money to do their taxes. They're not very tech savvy, so they have somebody do their taxes for them. And my parents went to go... give the money to the lady, and the envelope was empty. It was $250.
What efforts have they made to get her out of the house? Have they issued ultimatums, changed locks?
My dad has tried to make her leave, but my mom is very much a pushover.
She's the enabler. Mom's the enabler.
But it upsets me because, my parents, they want to retire. My mom's a school teacher. My dad's a mechanic. He was in the Army for a very long time. And the fact that my sister just doesn't respect my parents, I mean, she's constantly going to Ravens games and Orioles games and going out to bars with her friends. And
Is she someone that, and I've heard of this before because there's people in and around my family, that she doesn't live with her parents. Her parents live with her. Does she sell it to other people when they're like, how are you going to Ravens games? How are you going out? How are you hitting the scene and then going home? How does she sell it to people that she's like this?
I'm really not sure. I know that with my parents, she's like, oh, well, my boyfriend bought me tickets. And, she always constantly tells my mom, well, he has passes. He has passes. He gets them from work. Well, her boyfriend doesn't do that. I mean, and the thing is that, she's over his house more than she's at home with my parents, but then she comes home and asks for money, and then my mom doesn't give it to her.
I thought she works full-time.
She does work full-time, but she doesn't make enough money to even pay her car.
Oh, wow. God. Well, thank you for the call, love. Damn. Thank you so much. Mike, I'm going to put her on hold.
I want to get her sister on the air.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe get her info. See if we can get the sister on the air. I'd love a point counterpoint. Maybe there's someone in Buck's family. The reason I brought that example up, this guy sucks. He's a wannabe rapper. He's got a $40,000 automobile, $10,000 with a tricked outedness to it, lives in the guest bedroom of his retired parents' homes and tells people that they live with him. And it's like, you know, you don't, you zilch. You're just draining them dry. Let's go to... Oh, wow. Amon in Hyattsville. This sounds like the story that Josh just did. Good morning. Amon, am I saying that right?
Damon.
Damon. Okay. It says Amon here. Damon. All right. What's up?
Hey. Yeah. It was 4 years ago. She's out now.
Good.
But 4 years ago, it was the daughter and had dropped out of school and, you know, wasting my cash. And I said, okay, it's time for you to go. And after sending the notes the whole nine yards trying to push, I finally did take her to court. And unfortunately, at that point in time, I had filed the wrong type of tenant paperwork because she wasn't a tenant because, again, she was not paying rent.
Right.
And basically, the judge said, okay, here you are. You know, if you don't do something, then 2 weeks later, she would be... in the same situation, and he put her out. Well, that didn't, sit with her too well, and she ended up staying in the house for another year while I tried to give her some more chance. And then finally, she found a friend, and they ended up moving out. And that was 4 years ago.
And how is the relationship now?
As I say, she does what, grown people do. She calls every now and then. I do still pay her phone bill.
Does she resent you, though? Is she pissed at you for booting her out?
I don't know. I can't really tell. You know, starving artist, as far as I know.
And refresh me again. How old is she now?
Be 24.
And you're paying her phone bill.
That's young. 24, man.
Pay her phone bill.
It's tough.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you for the call. But yeah,
that's still young.
That's in the window of acceptability. Now, if she's stealing stuff and doing all that sort of crap like the prior caller, no good. Let's see who else been holding here for a second. Let's go to Taylor in Brunswick. Taylor, good morning. Talking about people that fail to launch.
Hello. So I've been living with my parents on and off. When I was 16, I moved in with my father. And then I think around 2 years ago, I moved back with my mom. She was with a guy who was less than... productive and less than beneficial for her, so she had requested that I move back to help her stay mentally stable.
Right.
Since then, I do things around the house. Like I think last week, I hooked up a dishwasher, I replaced lights. I hold my own. I do my chores.
Okay. So you helped
out. No problem with that.
You
she asked you to move back in because she needed a little support system. You're contributing. I'm all good with everything I just heard.
I got no problem with that. I got no problem with that at all. Let's go ahead and talk to James in Baltimore, who is the provider. You say you've still got two girls living at home. What are the ages?
It's actually two boys, 21, 24, and they moved their girlfriends in.
Oh, so you have two girls living at home with your... Oh, my
so
God.
Your
boys what fresh
are
hell is
yeah,
that?
Yeah, how much sex is going on in that house? Ugh. Jesus! What's going on over there?
Yeah. It's definitely out of control to the point that I actually made the decision with my 10-year girlfriend that I'm moving out.
Wow. So where are you guys going? So you're just leaving the house? You're abandoning the fort while the savages overtake it?
There's warning beforehand.
And whose kids are these? Your kids?
They're not my kids. They're her kids.
Oh, brother.
So she's got a 21 and 24-year-old boy. Boys, they still live at home, and now their girlfriends have moved in. Yeah, hit the road, dude.
Hit the road,
Jack.
Go.
Go
by yourself. Go by yourself. Start afresh. Start fresh.
Definitely happening. Definitely happening.
There he goes.
Mike's is line three.
Let's go to line three. Let's talk to Bonnie, Chesapeake Beach. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm seeing some numbers on screen here that might set a record.
Unfortunately, yes.
Go ahead. What is
yeah,
it?
My 69-year-old brother, he works, but my mom makes his bed, does his laundry, cooks for him. He can't, he doesn't want to take care of himself.
How old is she?
69?
She'll be 88 in July.
Oh, your mom is 88, and she's taking care of your 69-year-old brother who still lives at home.
And my 58-year-old brother hasn't had a job in 30 years and says, well, I didn't ask to be born.
Oh, wow. They suck.
Wow. Oh. Any kind of mental disabilities there with either of them?
My older brother, no. But my younger brother, I think so.
Okay. Well, then the older
brother. I don't think he's ever been treated for anything, but, He's my mommy's baby.
Oh, meanwhile, you're out there pounding the pavement, keeping a roof over your own head, doing the damn thing. Is that frustrating for you? Being like, why did I have to work so hard? And meanwhile, they're just getting a ticket to ride.
Well, like I said, you know, I enjoy my life. I've been out since I was 18. I joined the military and did my own thing, and I have been enjoying life where my younger brother, he's been up in his room most of the time.
Oh,
it's like, really?
God. Yeah, there's got to be something going on. That's insane!
Yeah, that's not an existence.